To remove the title bar from the image viewer, we need to set the Enable Visible Header property to false. Then, let's move on to the overlay. First, we must add some references to this application. We will add Presentation Core, Presentation Framework, and Windows Base. This allows us to use shapes for overlays. Let's then insert the code for the overlay. There is quite a bit of code which defines the overlay. It includes the font, font size, font style, color, and other parameters. Spend some time looking at it and it will make sense. The last line adds the overlay to the image viewer. SelectedItem.name is the actual string that we will use for the overlay. It is the name of the camera in this case, but you could use any information in your own application. The overlay will get a unique ID, a GUID, which you can reference if you need to update the information in the overlay, which will often be the case. Let's save the application and run it. We are logged in. Let's select a camera to verify the overlay is working. It says parking lot, just as it's supposed to. We can also see that the title bar is removed. If we zoom in, we can see that the overlay scales as well. You will have full control over that and many other aspects, which are outlined in the documentation. Let's select another camera just to confirm that the application works. It is working, as expected.